It's vile treachery is what it is. Vile treachery, and there's only one clan to blame. I'd sooner trust my life to a giant boar than to trust it to a MacGuffin. I sensed them lurking, watching me from the shadows. First I thought they were assassins sent by MacGuffin, but then I thought that's just what MacGuffin wants me to think. And then I thought, what if thinking that is what he wants me to think instead? Oh, I bet it is, the manky old bull. Now, it's 3 days later and I'm sure that MacGuffin has sent a bloodthirsty redcap to murder me in my sleep. Let's send Lord MacIntosh to watch out for the redcap. Ha! There! Taste the sharp end of my mace, you fall-hearted goblin! You... Oh, wait. That was a robin. Well, you can't blame me for being watchful when there's a malevolent goblin with a pikestaff on the loose now, can you? If he does soak his cap in his victim's blood, as they say, it won't be the blood of a MacIntosh. Well, Lord MacGuffin stalked off to who knows where. I can hear Lord MacIntosh nattering on about redcaps from the bushes. And the games were meant to have started an hour ago, so it looks as if I'll have to manage this without... That's odd. I'm sure that bit of splintered wood wasn't there on the ground before. Is it witching? It is. Well, the games can wait another few moments. Let's send Queen Eleanor to investigate. Och, I'm tired of jumping at shadows. To defeat this otherworldly fiend MacGuffin set on me, I'll have to outsmart it. Think, what else do the stories say about the redcap? Anything that could tell me its weaknesses? Long sharp talons, fearsome eye but unhelpful, boots made of iron, irrelevant, unless I want to kick at its chins. Wait, aha! That's it! The clue that will lead me straight to the beast's den. Let's build the ruins of the kingdom. A tribute to Clan MacIntosh. Queen Eleanor's a fine woman indeed, but far too trusting for her own good, which means it's up to me and me alone. Until a certain traitor arrives at the tournament grounds, I'll slay any fairy assassins that may precede him. In between tosses of the caber, of course, I didn't plan to give MacIntosh the satisfaction of my forfeiting the game. Let's slay, fairy assassins? So, after some examination, I've discovered a trail of twitching wood splinters all through the forest. Which means either Lord MacIntosh and Lord MacGuffin were right all along about magical beasts, or... No, saying it out loud makes me realize how vanishingly small of a possibility it is. And I'd sooner believe we've been invaded by mad stonemasons than give credence to those two. That trail of splinters leads all the way to the castle's back entrance, and it looks recent. Whatever's caused all this bedlam today, I have a feeling it's behind that door. I'd better open it quietly. Lord MacGuffin's been stealthily tromping behind me whenever he thinks I'm not looking. If the clans ever need to appoint a spymaster, we'll be sore put. There's not a clandestine soul among them. Let's send Queen Eleanor to sneak into the castle, and let's send MacGuffin to try to keep tabs on Eleanor. I can't believe I didn't think of it before! Redcap's hound ruined castles, especially castles that were home to wicked deeds. Of course, they are said to prefer ruins far to the south of here, but this one could have moved! Aye, and likely at MacGuffin's personal request too. That great galumphing ox is practically a lowlander himself. Och, best forget you heard that. Some accusations are too grave even for me to make. There's only one cursed ruin I know of near here. Aye, I bet that's where I'll find Redcap. Doing away with it will be a challenge, of course, but I'm more than prepared. The tales say the Redcap is unaffected by human strength, but they don't say anything about immunity to great spiky clubs. Let's send Lord MacIntosh to charge into the ruins. I think I scared it. Away. Somewhere in between crashing through the floor and shattering every piece of crockery in the cellar. All of which, I might add, hide it. On purpose. Besides, I can't be responsible for the consequences when I'm ablaze with righteous battle fury. The Redcap itself may have eluded me for the moment, but the man who sent it, well, I know exactly where he is. And I've a long walk back to the tournament grounds to plan what I'll do about it. Let's send MacIntosh to plot MacGuffin's downfall. How do I know this isn't some sort of trick? There's a scratching noise coming from inside the trophy room. Who could have gotten in there without the guards knowing? Hello? Is anyone... Hello, Mum. Sorry I'm late to the games. I'll run over there now. Please don't go in the trophy room. Love you. Goodbye. Somehow that was even more ominous than Lord MacGuffin's remark about the capers earlier. My battle plan is set. I'll join in the games, act as normal, then trip MacGuffin in a pile of manure for all to see. It's simple, aye, but that's the idea. It's so simple, MacGuffin will never expect a genius like me to come up with it. That's just elementary warfare tactics, that is. Ha! No more suicide attacks, and I've heard far less of them fluttering about in the bushes too. My fearsome demeanor must have scared them off before they dared assault me again. Or could some mysterious third party be slaying them in my stead, to clear the way to strike at me themselves? This can only mean one thing. Dingwall treachery is afoot! He must have had it out for me the whole time. I'd stake my favorite spear on it.
Hi, Merida.
firstborn descendant of Clan Dunbrog, hereby declare these games open!
Merida?
May the competition be as spirited as it is honorable, and may it draw our clans closer together in friendship.
I went into the trophy room, Merida.
Not now, Mom! And may the best man or woman win! With a fine display of skill at arms from Lord McIntosh, we are at a tie.
All without starting a war. Well done keeping them focused on the games instead of each other's throats, Merida.
Oh, thanks, Mum.
You're very welcome. Now tell them to take a break so you can explain to me what I saw in the trophy room.
Yes, Mum.
Now, everyone, to the refreshment stand for drinks and cakes.
Merida said she'd speak to me after a quick trip to the refreshment stand, but she's certainly taking her time about it. Either she's putting off having to tell me what she's been up to, or... Well, I'm quite sure she's done with magical cakes, but if she does bring me one, the two of us are sharing it! Let's welcome Merida!